Hi, I'm John Kaminsky from Penn State University, and we're here at Pine Acres Country Club in Bradford, Pennsylvania, looking at some of our snowmole trial work. This year the pressure was pretty high, probably some of the highest pressure we've ever had in our trials, and we have about 80 to 100% snow mold in our untreated control plots. So we've heard a lot of reports this year about people who had winter kill issues, not so much around this part of Pennsylvania, but snow mold certainly was a major problem. So this year we looked at several trials or several experimental products, both some that are not quite on the market yet and that'll be available hopefully in the next few years, and also some commercially available products. The products that we tested this year were from some companies that all of you probably know, Syngenta, Bayer, and also QualiPro. Okay, so this year we had four snow mold trials out of two different golf courses. We had Pine Acres Country Club, where I am right now. We also had Smethport Golf Club about a half hour from here, and we had a fairway trial at both locations as well as a putting green trial. In this location, I think that the fairway trial is the one that panned out. We've got quite a bit of disease. The putting green was mostly pink snow mold and not so severe. In this case, what we're dealing with is gray snow mold. You can tell by the sclerotia that we see in the tissue that it's Typhula incarnata, which is pretty common around here. If we were further north or up in the Wisconsin area, they may have some other Typhula species. But when we do get gray snow mold here, it's usually Typhula incarnata.
Okay, we're back in the office. We had a chance to look at some of the data from the plots. I'll just briefly start out with an overview of what the trial looked like. You can see we had some pretty variable results here with some high pressure in some plots, no disease in others, and variable disease in some other plots. And so we had a pretty good representation of control with the different treatments. Now, I made a longer version of this video, and I'll link to it at the end, but I just wanted to kind of summarize quickly what we saw in our trials here. In this year's trials, we saw that just about every single treatment that we put in resulted in a significant reduction in snow mold when you compared it to our untreated controls. The one exception to that was the low rate of PCNB. Under the pressure that we had, that 6 ounce rate of PCNB just isn't going to cut it, and you really need the higher rate. If we look at some of the treatments that provided the best control, in most cases what happened was treatments that had a tank mix or multiple products per treatment provided the best control, and those included some of the experimental products from Syngenta, as well as the four-way product Enclave, either applied alone or in combination with the QP strobe from QualiPro. A variety of other levels of control we saw, anywhere from 4 or 5 to 11% with some other products, and basically all this shows you is that despite these products normally working in a good year, although they provide a good control, they still had slight breakthrough because the pressure was so high. So we felt like we had a pretty good year with our snow mold trials, and we look forward to going back to this site again. In summary, you can see that there are various experimental products as well as some that are commercially available, but in all cases we're talking about tank mix or multiple products within a single product, like Enclave, which has four different active ingredients. Those are the ones that seem to provide the best control. If you're going to stick with PCNB, if that's your go-to for your snow mold, the low rate under high pressure is definitely not going to cut it, and we didn't even see a significant reduction in disease when we compared it to our untreateds in this case. It was only when we put out 12 ounces of PCNB that we got adequate control. So with that, I definitely have to thank the cooperators. I'll thank the superintendents, Jason Culver and Jim Askey at Pine Acres and Smethport Country Club. Without them, we wouldn't have had these trials, and they welcomed us back for next year, so I'm looking forward to that. I'd like to thank our research cooperators as well as our staff. I will mention, if you want to watch the long version of this, you can click on the link in the upper right-hand corner. And if you have any suggestions or comments about treatments that we might add for our 2015 and 2016 trials, just leave a comment in the comments below, and we'll take a look at that, and some of those may get included in next year's trial. All right, this is John Kaminsky from Penn State. I appreciate you listening, and good luck in 2015.